We found a boat, then sailed away from the island. We had to. We didn't belong there. The new guy's name was George. I noticed when the anarchist said his name, he said it with a thick Belkan accent.
How did you know that he was from Belka?
Well, both my parents were from Belka, so...
You never told me that. They say that Belkans are known for their conspiracies.
That's just a stereotype. I simply stated my honest opinion and was thrown in jail for it.
The princess sat there looking miserable. That was a dumbass stunt she pulled back there, but it got us on this boat.
Take a look at that. This ship is heading for a single rope that's hanging down from the sky. Do you know how far the end of that rope reaches? Outer space. No. It is a direct connection to the very potential of mankind itself. Or at least it was until war erupted. It's my strong belief that the rope might be connected to a very distant, faraway source of great conflict and strife. Even long before the war, the whole world started falling apart once Harling began trying to build it. I often wonder what was going through Harling's mind when he was trying to destroy the very thing that so many people were sacrificed in order to create.
Sacrificed? What do you mean?
Have you seen all of those countless old space shuttles on Tyler Island that are no longer in use?
Yeah. I always thought of them as a good source of scrap. They're an obsolete technology that was abandoned during the construction of the space elevator. Which would mean that if the space elevator was destroyed, it would be that much harder for mankind to reach the stars. Until we find another way.
But even then, Harling still went ahead and tried to destroy it. At the cost of his own life.
That's not the way I heard it. What I heard was that he sacrificed himself to protect the tower from an incoming missile.
Oh, I was told he tried to fly his ship into the tower in order to destroy it.
I wonder which story is true, Your Royal Highness.
The first one. Very clearly.
I don't know. Looking at it objectively, it's reasonable to believe that Harling had both options before him.
When it comes to which one you think he took, I guess it's like a mirror.
Yes, it is. It's like a mirror looking into your own soul, based on whichever choice you believe it was. At the moment, though, I can only see darkness. I think that thing should be destroyed.
Start Morning, the Clark. Briefing. Although, since we don't have any contact with HQ, it's not like this is an official mission. Anyway, it looks like the seizure of Tyler Island and the relief from Osea have been postponed. In the meantime, we just have to do what we can to survive. Since losing its capital city of Ferbanti, Eurusian forces have separated into smaller, autonomous factions. It looks like Eurusia's largest force and leading faction will pass through the area around this base. The space elevator is significant to them. So, they're probably heading there.
Should we intercept?
Why? I doubt they're gonna start a fight now.
Our top priority should be to get home. Let's go already.
Yeah. It's not like we have the supplies, power, or even a real reason to put up a fight. But what are we going to do if they bring the fight to us? We need to be ready to push them back. If we head inland from here towards Arusha, there's an old castle that's been converted into a stockpiling base. Shilaji Castle.
Dun dun dun.
It's currently occupied by some of the Arusian forces that broke off, but we need ammo and fuel. They appear to have converted a freeway into a runway, so we can expect them to have the capacity for air combat. But they'll be easier to handle than Arusha's lead faction. While we can't use all our aircraft to attack, the transport carrying the stolen supplies needs support. Okay, Strider Squadron. You head out first and neuter the dogs at the stockpiling base.
With missiles.
Rendezvous with Cyclops Squadron, who will bring the transport. Then we bring the supplies back to this base.
Got it.
Aircraft are our only threat.
Sounds good.
We'll make it. We're all gonna fly home. Together.
Sorry if you like shit, Flare. If it's allergies, they're starting to get me too. Alright. I have done some practicing in a free mission, so hopefully I don't stink up the place like I did last time. We are basically sticking with the HVAAs for the rest of the game, except for one little bit, in the last few seconds of the final mission. This is the end of ground combat. Completely. So, we're just going to stick with these. Let's just go ahead and use what we got. Am I just using Strider? Yeah, alright.
Strider Squadron, aircraft prep complete. You're cleared to taxi.
Hopefully he doesn't drop like it did last time.
Ocean forces are in the region ahead. No allies here. No need to ID your target. We've set a number of priority targets, focusing on their anti-aircraft weaponry. Okay, team. Get to work. Unidentified aircraft. Not sure if friend or foe. Fire anyway. We don't have
foe. Foe was fucked.
So, we capture this base and take the fuel and supplies. That's the plan, right, Trigger?
Take what you want to live. That's how it was where I grew up.
I was just double-checking mission orders,
Hoosier. Our AI air guns are destroying. Abandon and fall back to our rear position.
Machine gun range.
So, if you basically kill everything...
Vehicles along the road.
So, if you kill everything really fast on your way to this base, that will get the ace to spawn. I don't think the theatrics are going to let up until I get, even after I get there. So, I'm just going to, just say that while it's paused.
So, we'll open fire.
What is he talking about? They already are firing on us. The enemy's confused.
I know.
Rider 1, target eliminated.
Strider 1, target acquired.
How did it miss?
So what's this faction split from the Arusian military?
Oh shit. I need to be more sensible with my missiles. Shit. I'm gonna need those.
You'll have enough AA weapons.
Here we go. Yeah, this is kind of messed up.
Enemy on your back. Set up AA weapons. Put them on a flat
surface. Missile. 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 Gotta get behind you. Shit. That's, yeah, but they won't know shit. They won't know how to do shit.
Destroyed. AA destroyed. We're sitting ducks. Cancel
Yeah, back me up, please.
These guys are pretty good.
Nicole.
Been hit. He's injected. Damn it. We can't even last long enough to buy ourselves some time.
Oh, here we go.
At high speed, bearing 090, straight from the east.
It's a wyvern with a railgun on it.
High speed protected launch from the aircraft.
Woo! Holy shit! Come on, motherfucker! There you go.
It's a hit. The unidentified aircraft is going down.
You got him. Trigger has splashed a bandit.
Can you hear me? Pilot with the three strikes. This was all due to my ego. I unleashed pure chaos upon this world just so I could keep my wings. Put a stop to the drone production.
Is this a message to Trigger? What does it mean?
I don't think this war is over just because we shot down Mr. X. Yeah, it's gonna take something else entirely to end this thing. I just don't know what.
Forces are in the region ahead.
It takes stopping the drone production. It takes the thing he's telling you to stop. You need to stop. You should stop that, and then the war will end. That's what he just said.
The resupply went well. We should be okay on food and fuel reserves for a little while at least. Luckily, the rumor that the Arusian army is advancing nearby is only a rumor. There's no sign of them from the skies.
Rumors.
Rumors, rumors. This is what happens when you lose communications. But we got one good fact. The plane Trigger shot down was an advanced model of the XO2 Wyvern. It was developed in the last Continental War. Erugia had a lot up their sleeves. Apparently, they were even supposed to have Belkan aircraft back in the First War. What if Trigger couldn't shoot it down? Just thinking about it gives me chills. We're lucky to be here. In war, you never know what's lurking behind the curtains. But it looks like everything's loose now. Solid chain of command, rest periods after sorties, a battlefield where you know friend from foe. All of that's gone now, lost in a fog of confusion. Feels like a distant dream. Now, just how the hell are we gonna get out of this mess?
By stopping the drone production. The thing that he was telling you to do.
When we got to the mainland, we found the space elevator's support facility. I guess this was the factory where they built the gigantic structure the elevator traveled in. There was this little girl sitting in front of a mural. When the princess saw her, she shuddered like she'd seen a ghost. The girl had a stuffed animal. This was the day after the shit went down at Tyler Island. She walked right up to the princess, took her hand, and led her into the factory. One thing's for sure, they knew each other. The factory'd been converted to a production line for Arusian drones. It was fully automated and chugging along, making drone after drone after drone. Once they got inside, the princess stopped and just stood there. Another girl was there with a man in a lab coat. He was trying to use his keyboard, but she wouldn't let him. She took a data chip and threw it on the ground. Then she walked over to us and took the gun from the prison guard's holster. She pulled the trigger and destroyed the chip. Later, I found out that the girl with the gun and the one with the stuffed animal were sisters. They were also the granddaughters of Mihai A. Shilaji, the legendary pilot. Gramps used to talk about him. He said Mihai was the top ace from two wars ago. Know any Belkans? Because this guy was a Belkan, and they love to stir shit up. Pitting nations against other nations is a particular favorite of theirs, along with developing hyper-advanced technology.
That's right. I'm Belkan, born and raised.
Belka!
My country is gone now. Rather than surrender to its enemy, Belka detonated 7 nuclear weapons on its own soil. My people scattered around the globe, living in the shadows of other countries. We had a new purpose, to breed wars. The theory was that through war, we could achieve our destiny and our revenge. I had just finished inputting Mihai's data when his granddaughter came in. She destroyed the only copy I had of the information I squeezed out of him. The girl loved Mihai. No one knew more than her just how hard I pushed her grandfather for that data, how much I made him sacrifice in the process. I promised his granddaughters that his efforts were not in vain, that it could end this terrible war. But in the end, it only caused more chaos and despair. We were responsible for all this damage, all this tragedy. Now, we were going to pay for it. The Arusians, once our allies, would see to that. I had lost the drive to continue my work, even before before I noticed Mihai's granddaughters eyeing me with suspicion that one day. I should have stopped then. For all our sakes. Mihai's granddaughter tossed the gun aside. She said if she resorted to killing, she'd just end up like the rest of us. And by us, she meant everyone, including the princess. Like me, the princess was afraid to look into the girl's eyes. She knew that by encouraging her people, she kept the war going. Mihai and his granddaughter were victims of it, and now, they too were paying the price.
Is this for Belka? Or for Erugia? My grandfather had only one wish, to continue soaring through the endless skies. That was the only place where he felt alive. But I don't even have a country to call home, let alone the sky. The Black Forest, the lake, they are no longer mine. Even though those lands were once cherished by my late mother. We have to learn to put that sense of nostalgia behind us and behave like mature adults.
My homeland. She's right. It feels so far away now. The woman with the rifle approached me. She was focused on more pressing issues.
I checked the computer. All of the data on the legendary Ace had already been installed.
No, I pulled it before it was completed. However, there are two aircraft that are already scheduled to be manufactured based on that data.
We must destroy the factory.
This isn't the only one. There are more facilities just like it, and the two planes containing the data will be manufactured at one of those facilities.
So, this place runs on solar power that the space elevator generates, right? How about the others?
We can destroy the space elevator and cut the power to them. First things first, let's take this one out.
I'll show you which locations to target.
I stood there, thinking about that mural by the factory's entrance. Harling commissioned it to be painted. I realized that in the background, behind the dancing figures, the artist had painted several space elevators. I understand now. The space elevator wasn't designed to exploit Erugia after all.
Good. And afterwards, we'll bring down the space elevator itself. No matter why it was built, right now, it's the root of this chaos.
I wonder.
Yes?
I wonder which path you would choose. When looking at Harling's mirror.
What the hell are you talking about?
Thank you.